In this question, we have to find the equivalent capacitance between A and B. So this is 2 microfarad, 2 microfarad, these are all 2 microfarad, these are all 1 microfarad. When you look at it, it seems very complicated. Because see, this capacitor and this capacitor, they are not in parallel. Why? Because there is a capacitor connected in between. Similarly, this and this, they are not in parallel because this is connected in between. Again, this and this are not in series because there is a connection here. Similarly, this and this are not in series because there is a connection here. So that means when you look at it first, you see that these capacitors are not in parallel and they are not in series. Now to solve a circuit like this, the trick is to start from the furthest point. So the trick is you should start from the furthest point. What does it furthest point means? So we have to find the equivalent capacitance between the A and B. So what is furthest from here? This end. So we start from the furthest point or furthest end. You can say furthest point or furthest end. So we'll start from here. So if you look here, you see that these 2 microfarad and these 2 microfarad, they are in series. See? They are in series. So we can reduce it to 1 capacitor. So if I draw 1 capacitor instead of those 2, so 2 microfarad and 2 microfarad in series, so it becomes 1 microfarad. The equivalent is 1 microfarad. So this 1 microfarad is already here. And then this 2 microfarad, this 1 microfarad. I'm not drawing the whole thing. This is 2, this is 1, again 2 here, again 1 here. It goes like that. Now, once you reduce it from this to this, now look here. This 1 microfarad and this 1 microfarad, these 2 capacitors are in parallel. So find the equivalent of that. So equivalent of that will be 1 capacitor. So this one, its capacitance will be 2 microfarad. 1 plus 1 is 2 since they are in parallel. So this reduces to this. Then this 2 microfarad is there. Then this 1 microfarad is there, so these will remain. Now see, this circuit is similar to that. Here 2 microfarad and 2 microfarad were in series, it got reduced, then again these were in parallel, it got reduced. So now this 2 microfarad and 2 microfarad are in series, combination is in parallel with this. This is 1 microfarad. So we can proceed like this. If we proceed like this, so at this point, what we'll see that at this point we'll get a 2 microfarad capacitor. We'll get a 2 microfarad capacitor at this point, and this will be connected to another 2 microfarad here, this one. This is point B, this is point A. So we have come to this situation. So this 2 microfarad and this 2 microfarad, they are in series, so their equivalent capacitance is 1 microfarad. So if we combine these two, their equivalent capacitance will be 1 microfarad. So this is the answer. I hope you have understood. See, what we have done is, the trick in situations like this is, again I am repeating it, we have to find the capacitance here. So we start from the furthest end. So furthest end is this. So here we see this and this, these two are in series. So their equivalent is 1 microfarad here. This is in parallel with this. So So their equivalent is 2. These 2 and these 2 microfarad, they are in series. So the situation has become similar to the first one. So once we find this equivalent resistance, sorry, equivalent capacitance, one branches will keep reducing. So at this point, when we arrive at this point, in here the capacitance will get at 2 microfarad. That will be in series with this 2 microfarad. So the resultant or the final equivalent capacitance will be 1 microfarad.